Hello everyone, Akash here. The fundamental difference between mindset, the rich and the poor is, the rich understand a very simple principle. Money makes money. Rich people see money as an opportunity, but the poor people see it as something to be earned. We always hear about rich and the poor, the glory of the rich and the struggle of the poor. So the question is, can it be changed? Also the question is there a particular definition for either category? Also, who we are really talking about when it comes to rich versus poor? So who are the rich? The simple way to say it, rich people are associated with money, asset, and a higher quality of life. These assets are included and not limited to stocks, bonds, and real estate. Also, rich people not necessarily to appear rich. So who are the poor people? The poor people who live beyond their means, and most of them don't have any money or asset, and also most of them have negative net worth because of accumulated toxic debt from credit card and payday loan. Basically, poor people are associated with low level of money and the lower quality of life. So what makes up in mindset? Mindset basically can be used to categorize people. These common beliefs like spending habit and relationship with money also help segregate rich and the poor. Let's go through in this video 5 key difference between rich versus poor and what can you do about it to close the gap. Also, if you do a lot of shopping online, you could get up to 20% cash back using Rakuten app. That would be really good saving for you every month, the things you personally would buy it anyway. Also, you get $40 sign up bonus. You'll find the link in the description box. Also, you could follow me on Instagram. You'll find the link in description box. The first key difference between rich versus poor, compounded interest work for the rich and against the poor. Rich people basically make money to work for them instead of just working and relying on income only. Rich person will take a promotion of the income by investing it. Compounded interest works really well for the rich because it will eventually turn 1,000 into 10,000 over time. Most often, rich person could choose not to work and live off revenue generated through investment. But most of the rich works because they like what they do, not because they need money. Poor people work for money. Most often they neither save or invest it. A poor person see $1,000 just $1,000. Most often poor person work paycheck to paycheck rest of their life with very little saving. Poor people are really good at spending everything they earn, basically buying stuff from the rich, whether they need it or not. Most often they have nothing left at the end of the month. But the real issue is when people spend money which they don't have, accumulate in credit card debt, paying high interest on those cards, basically $1,000 debt turned into $10,000 over time. The second key difference between rich versus poor, rich people's expenditure versus poor people's expenditure. Rich people basically spend on necessities and what is really needs, not what is desired. Give you example. If a rich person run out of eggs, they will walk into a grocery store to buy eggs, nothing more. Also, a rich person with a perfectly working phone, they wouldn't go and spend money on a new phone. Rich people don't care about trends. They care about their net worth. A poor person will spend on both necessities and desire. Give you example. If a poor person run out of eggs, they will walk into a grocery store and get more than just the eggs. Most often, a poor person spend beyond their means and they do care about the latest trend. Poor people care about their image a lot more than their net worth. The third key difference between rich versus poor. Rich people always think about long-term goals. But the other hand, poor people live on instant gratification. Rich people always think about long-term goals, which is increasingly hard in our society that is driven by instant gratification. Poor people are really good at setting up short-term goals or none. Often they do not see the necessity of long-term goals, such as money for future living, especially when a crisis hit. Making ends meet gets very difficult, sometimes nearly impossible. Give you example. During the COVID time, poor person suffer tremendously from the lack of saving. The fourth key difference between rich versus poor, attitude towards risk. Rich people tend to be risk taker. A rich person most likely to take calculated risk. The reason they do that, because they can afford. Also, they have diversified assets. Give you an example. When a rich person gets an opportunity to invest in a startup company, they will most likely calculate the risk of that investment. If the estimate is satisfactory, at that point, rich persons see this is a chance to increase their wealth. On the other hand, poor people tend to be risk average. Give you an example. If a poor person gets an opportunity to invest in a startup company, a poor person most likely to immediately turn this down. They do not see this as a chance to increase their wealth. Most often they see this as reduction of their disposable income. Fifth key difference between rich versus poor: attitude towards learning. Rich people are eager to learn. Biggest return come from education, not from compounded interest or from bonds and stocks or even from real estate. If you look at most millionaires in United States, they were not born millionaires. They learned some point in life how to build wealth. The more they learn, the more they understood the world. The rich recognize they don't know everything, and they're not afraid to seek advice because they understand something can be learned from everyone. On other hand, poor people not eager to learn. Basically, most often they don't enjoy learning. They care about instant gratification. They care about more what people think about them, and they care about their image. Basically, they do not know what they don't know. Most often they dislike hearing opposing perspective and quickly feel insecure when challenged. But a poor person enjoy dreaming about being rich because most of them believe rich are either born rich or got lucky. They do not recognize because they are poor because of their lifestyle choice. So you could be rich or you could be a poor, or you could be between rich and poor. Honestly, that is okay, but it's very important. The first step is recognize where you stand and how you would like to move forward. Also, what type of mindset do you possess? You have to think about, do you want to make money to work for you, or do you want to work for the money? It is in your hand. No one will care about your finance the way you do. So get started today. Set goals, save money. Think about long-term saving. It's never too late. Hope this video was helpful to you. Many great videos you'll find in my channel. Consider subscribing to my channel. Take care.